So where was I?
Shepard, there you are.
Dr. Chakwas, you're here?
I'm working at an Alliance R&D lab down in Shelter Wards, coordinating closely with Admiral Hackett. I heard you escaped Earth in the Normandy, and that someone was critically injured. I came as fast as I could.
We had a run-in with a Cerberus synthetic on Mars. Caden took the worst of it. How is he doing?
Very well, all things considered. I'm impressed with Major Alenko's resilience, as well as Dr. Michelle's expertise. I wish I could have been there to help on Mars.
It's been 6 months, Doctor. How have you been?
Good. I've been fortunate. When they impounded Normandy, the Alliance didn't really know what to do with me. I was never officially part of Cerberus, and I'd gotten a proper leave of absence from my previous post.
So you hadn't technically done anything wrong by joining me to defeat the Collectors?
Yes. Though I suppose if you were judged to be a war criminal, I would have been tried as an accessory.
Your place is in Normandy's medbay, not some lab.
I couldn't agree more. You say the word, and I'm with you.
The Normandy wouldn't be the same without you, Doctor. Get your things. Docking bay D-24.
Yes, Commander. And thank you.
Don't thank me so soon. Remember, Joker's still aboard.
And I'd be surprised if he's been remembering his medication.
Welcome to Serta.
Thank you for coming to Serta. How can we help you? All profits from sales go to help new medical research.
Thank you for shopping.
Patient stable for now.
That was touch and go. Good work, Dr. Freilich.
Narrow splint's still the best course of action.
I'll see if we have the required spatial bindings. Meet you back here.
Hey, Caden. Don't know if you can hear me, but since you can't tell me to get the hell out either, I'm gonna take my chances. Get your ass out of this bed and back to your post, Major. Seeing you in action again reminded me you're a hell of a soldier. The Alliance could sure use you. You need anything, Doc, let me know. Come on, Caden. Fight. And that's an order.
Recent intel suggests that the entire Batarian hegemony has been destroyed.
Hi, Doctor. Didn't expect to see you again so soon.
Well, we need to prescribe you another round of antibiotics.
For when I ship out?
I have some bad news. Your squad applied the metagel correctly, but infection had already set in by the time they found you. I'm sorry. I'm afraid we have to remove your leg below the knee.
What? But... I don't understand. It doesn't even hurt.
It would if we took you off the painkillers, Lieutenant.
I guess we found everything here. Going to take a quick break to drink. Okay, and I'm back.
Hello, Commander Shepard. Welcome to Citadel Embassies. The current human ambassador is Dominic Osoba. Commander Bailey is the CSEC officer on duty. You will find him in the Citadel Security District office.
Where's the Spectre Requisitions office?
The Spectre Requisitions District office is down the hallway to your left. Note that requisition forms are available only to agents whose biometrics are verified and on file.
What else is in the area?
This area is reserved for human embassy personnel and attending CSEC security. The human embassy prides itself on offering swift assistance to any who fall under its auspices.
That's it. Thanks.
Please speak with me again if you require further assistance.
No, that's it, I guess.
Please tell the Primacy that the Vol Protectorate wishes to assist with the Alliance project. We had a Prothean obelisk that might have helped. Sadly, it was lost in the Shrike Abyssal. Nevertheless, we are committed to helping both the Turian Empire and the Human Alliance.
Incursions by enemy forces are being reported in Turian colonies. Fighting is said to reach power.
Hello, dear. Perhaps you can help me. I'm looking for my son.
But we spoke about this already. I told you about his mission and...
Nonsense. I just filled out the paperwork. He's very punctual when he's on the field. He checks in every week. Only, he hasn't checked in for a while now. A month. Anyway, I'd like to file an expedited contact request.
Yes.
Hey, Mickey. Okay, it's good.
Ma'am, but the notes on his file state he's not under a contact ban.
Oh, you already looked. How kind of you. I'm just so worried. It's not like him to go quiet.
As soon as I get news, ma'am, I'll let you know as soon as I get news.
Thank you. You're such a nice young woman. You know, you remind me of my daughter-in-law.
There is no anti-humanity conspiracy here, Ms. Al-Jilani. The Council's simply not granting interviews at this time.
My viewers are going to know that CSEC and the Council are denying them access.
Listen, lady, you think I like playing gatekeeper between the paparazzi and the politicians? I don't have time to babysit them, and I'm not here to hold your hand.
Well, I'm camping out until I'm granted an audience.
Fine. I hope you brought a sleeping bag.
Commander Shepard? Commander Humanity has questions.
Right.
Damn press.
See, you're keeping the peace?
Yeah, I feel like a glorified doorman.
Most people would see it as a move up.
Wedged in here with all the stuffed shirts? I'd rather be back down on the streets. I appreciate the higher pay grade, but I'm not a political creature.
If you didn't want to be upped, why'd you accept?
You don't say no to Counselor Udina. Well, maybe you would, but I gotta live here. I know, squeaky wheel gets the oil, but I didn't lobby for a promotion like some other officers. I'm not even sure why he picked me. I never know with politicians. I hate political BS.
Politicians are the weeds of the galaxy.
If that was a bumper sticker, I'd stick it right here on my desk. It's killing me about Earth.
You and me both.
I haven't been back in years. Now I may never. If this ain't the end of days, it's pretty damn close.
Let's see if I can find... Oh yeah, there she is.
Commander Shepard! Commander, the people of the Alliance...
Commander Shepard, Khaleesi bint Seen and Al-Jilani. Isn't it true that you were on Earth when the Reapers attacked? How do you justify running away while millions of people on Earth die? Is that the best we can expect from the Alliance?
I came to get help for Earth. For everyone.
What about all the people suffering while you play politics with the Council? What about them? How can you stand here while our families die? What are you going to do?
The same thing I've been doing for the past 3 years. Find a way to stop the Reapers. Get some help, Kalisa. I have work to do.
The Council called the invaders Reapers. The same term once used by a disgraced
commission. Let's see if there's anything to get here. Nothing here.
Commander, Counselor Udina said you'd be coming. If you'll follow me, the council is already in session.
We've got our own problems, Counselor. Earth is not in this alone.
But Earth was the first council world hit. By our reports, it faces the brunt of the attack.
By your reports.
The reports are accurate. Earth was attacked by the Reapers. And it's just the beginning. We need your help. Everything you can spare.
Each of us faces a similar situation. Even now, the Reapers are pressing on our borders. If we lend you our strength to help Earth, our own worlds will fall.
We must fight this enemy together.
And so we should just follow you to Earth?
Yeah.
Even if we were to unite our fleets, do you really believe we could defeat the Reapers?
I don't expect you to follow me without a plan.
Counselors, we have that plan, a blueprint created by the Protheans during their war with the Reapers.
A blueprint for what?
We're still piecing it together, but it appears to be a weapon of some sort.
Capable of destroying the Reapers?
So it would seem.
The scales. It would be a colossal undertaking.
No. I forwarded the plans to Admiral Hackett. The remnants of the human fleet are already gathering resources to begin construction.
Our initial calculation suggests it is very feasible to build.
If we work together.
Have you considered that the Reapers destroyed the Protheans? What good did this weapon do?
It was incomplete. There was a missing component, here. Something referred to only as the Catalyst. But they ran out of time before they could finish building it.
Do you really believe this can stop the Reapers?
It sure as hell beats standing around and arguing about it. And while I haven't always agreed with Udina, he's right about this. We need to stand together, now more than ever. The Reapers won't stop at Earth. They'll destroy every organic being in the galaxy if we don't find a way to stop them.
The cruel and unfortunate truth is that while the Reapers focus on Earth, we can prepare and regroup.
We are convening a summit amongst our species. If we can manage to secure our own borders, we may once again consider aiding.
I'm sorry, Commander. That is the best we can do.
Yeah, Shepard, thanks for nothing.
Keep me in my office.
I hope that's an offer of support. I'll be digging up what I can on this Prothean device, Shepard.
They're a bunch of self-concerned jackasses, Shepard. We may have a spot in the Council, but humanity will always be considered second rate.
How can they be so blind?
They're scared, and they're looking out for themselves.
Our people are scared, and we are looking out for them the best we know how.
Counselor?
Commander, I can't give you what you need, but I can tell you how to get it.
I'm listening.
Primarch Vidorian called the War Summit, but we lost contact with him when the Reapers hit Palavin. Those meetings won't proceed without him. The Normandy is one of the few ships that can extract Primarch Vidorian undetected.
I told you this would happen, and you did nothing.
We can argue the past later if you like. But the leaders of this summit will be the ones deciding our future, the fate of our fleets, where they fight, and with whom. A grateful Primarch would be a tremendous ally in your bid to unite us.
We're at war, and you want me to play politician?
If it gets you what you need, what does it matter? Our latest intelligence says that the Primarch was moved to a base on Palavin's largest moon. I've done all I can to help. The rest is up to you. There is one other thing. The Council wanted me to tell you, we've chosen to uphold your Spectre status. And various resources will be made available to you. Good day.
Well, that went well.
Thanks, I guess.
I'll talk to the others in the meantime, see if we can support this summit, move things along.
Thanks.
Council, you saved their lives, and for what? Apologies that boil down to maybe later. If we don't figure out something, maybe later epitaph on a mass grave of 11 billion.
I know what I'm gonna do. What are you gonna do?
Humanity has created some goodwill in the galaxy. Now we cash in our chips. I will get what funding I can, what materials I can, and spread the message. Help the humans, help yourselves. I'll institute a draft in our colonies and order all civilian ships armed. Work on the Prothean device will be around the clock.
Any news from Earth?
There is constant news. All of it bad. The Reapers are destroying satellites and the old nuclear missile silos. Along with everything else that could help. We have a handful of quantum entanglers spread out over the continents. All other communication is cut.
What's your read on the counselors? Any angles I could pursue?
Tavos is a diplomat and compromiser, but she's wrapped up in defending Asari space like a mother panther. Valern is out of his depth. The Salarians like their wars won before they start. They're frightened now. Use that. In Sparatus, I'd take what he offers. It's strange days when the Turians are the least hostile to humans, and there's a need there.
You're a Citadel counselor. Don't you have options when the others block you like this?
With Parliament destroyed and Shastri gone, I have more power than any human in history. But today, you saw how little that is. Rest assured, I will not be counted out long. I know I can move mountains. Do not lose sight of that, because the task before us is moving planets.
Anderson would be proud, so long as you deliver. You think he can do that?
You need a carrot or a stick to drive a mule, and humanity has neither right now. Our armada is tied down fighting or fleeing, and with Earth's calm buoys gone, our economy is reduced to an IOU. But leave that part to me. I will lean on our colonies for all they're worth, and I can broker enough trade to repair and resupply Hackett's fleet.
Did you know a lot of people on Earth?
Many. It's monstrous to think of them being snuffed out, of course, but the part that gets me is Arcturus. I must have known most of the Alliance Parliament on a first-name basis. I required a second VI just to track all their birthdays and anniversaries. Rose Garden stuff. But to have it all gone.
Okay.
Go.
I'll be here.
Yeah, you'll be there. I guess nothing new here.
Hey, Commander. Liara told me the Council's not interested in helping us.
Something like that?
Why would they? Look at this place. There's no war here. People are whispering about it. They're talking about it. But they don't really believe it.
I take it this is your first time here with the elite of the galaxy.
I've been to the Citadel, but never up here on the Presidium. It's not right. It looks pretty, calm and peaceful. But it's not right. It's all just an illusion.
It was peaceful. Once.
But was it? Really? I mean, when push comes to shove, they're just gonna turtle up. Hope it don't hit them too, right? They'd rather believe in this than face the truth.
They're in for a rude awakening. Every species will fall one by one if they don't work with us.
No shit. Can't believe it's even up for debate.
So, you still want to go back to Earth?
Hell yeah, but...
But?
You were right. So was Anderson. We can't stop them alone. Besides, looks like you're gonna have your hands full convincing these pendejo politicians to help us. And I'm up for it. Whatever it takes.
Glad to hear it.
I'm gonna head down to some of the lower levels where they keep it real. You got some spare time? You should come and find me.
Maybe I'll do that.
Anyone else here? No, I don't think so, huh? Let's see if Thane is there. Yo, Mickey. Let's take a quick look. No, he's not there. Memorial Hospital. Welcome, Commander Shepard. One moment, please. No, wrong button. You're just in time for the next mission.
Now arriving at Presidium Embassy. Welcome, Commander Shepard. One moment, please.
What's going on here?
Commander, just who I was looking for. Diana Allers, Alliance News Network. I think we can help each other.
I don't have the greatest track record with reporters.
I know, and it hasn't exactly endeared you to a galactic audience, but that can change. I'm a military reporter with a show called Battle Space. We're carried on just about all Council planets. My producers want me embedded on a human ship, and I want that ship to be the Normandy.
Why would I want that?
Wars can be won or lost in the editing room, and this war needs to be won. I've got Alliance security clearance and operate without a crew. You get veto power over the segments I file. Can you handle an arrangement like that, or do I keep looking?
Tell your producers yes for now. We'll see how it works out. Report to the ship as soon as possible. Any questions?
How much gear can I bring?
One footlocker.
Aye, aye, Commander.
How's my microphone today? I hope it does work. Ah, okay, so it does work. Okay. Get back here. Now I got ya.
Liara, can I help you?
I've been forwarding the Turian Counselor information on the Prothean device. It can't be built without Council support, but he's not budging until their Primarch is safe.
I know.
Are you all right?
Just shaking off some sleep.
Commander Shepard, I'm Specialist... Oh. I beg your pardon. I thought you were alone.
I was just leaving.
Commander Shepard, I'm Comm Specialist Samantha Traynor with Alliance R&D. I was part of the team retrofitting the Normandy after you turned it over to the Alliance. There weren't many of us aboard when the Reapers hit.
I need the Normandy functional. What exactly have you done to my ship?
We upgraded communications and removed most of the Cerberus tech, Commander.
Meaning?
The ship's in line with Alliance regs now, and it has new, top-of-the-line, quantum entanglement communicators. In fact, Admiral Anderson had intended to use the Normandy as his mobile command center.
That's no longer an option.
Yes, I heard he chose to stay and fight. In any event, I'm honored to serve under you, Commander. For as long as you need me, that is. They only sent me here to oversee the retrofits.
Shepard. Some of our systems require further testing, and Specialist Traynor has been extremely effective during installation. I would prefer that she remain.
Got it, Edie.
Oh, wait, since when does a virtual intelligence make requests?
Edie's an AI. Fully self-aware.
Oh, I knew it. I knew Joker was lying.
Jeff requested that I pretend to be a simple VI to protect myself. I apologize for the deception.
Thanks, Edie, and I apologize for all those times I talked about how attractive your voice was. Anyway, shall I give you a tour? I think you'll be impressed by the new upgrades. In the CIC, you'll find the galaxy map where you can set the Normandy's destination. You can also check your messages at your private terminal. The War Room houses a strategic command center for mission-specific intel and war analysis. The shuttle bay contains an armory where you can modify your equipment between missions. Finally, Liara has set up a lot of hardware down in the
sort of, yeah.
On deck 3. I think she's claimed that room. And there you are. Still the same ship as before, it just flies Alliance colors now. Speaking of which, I believe Admiral Hackett would like to speak to you at the VidCom.
Commander, Udina updated me on your meeting with the Council. Sounds like they're running scared.
The Council's been a pain in my ass from day one. I'm done with them.
Then what's your plan?
I'm trying to get the Turian Primarch for a summit meeting with the Asari and Salarians. I'll bypass the Council and appeal directly to their leadership.
That's good, I like it. This is where we start laying the groundwork for our counterattack.
Unfortunately, we don't have a whole lot to back it up right now.
Then build alliances. Gather everything and everybody you can for the cause.
What about the Prothean device?
Find me people who can help build it, and if you can't, I'll take ships, soldiers, supplies, whatever you can get. We need to keep hitting the Reapers across every theater of war they open. Buy us time to figure out the device.
And when it's finished?
Assuming it ever is, we pool all our resources. Think of it as a giant armada for delivering the device when the Reapers are most vulnerable. The stronger you can make that armada, the better the chances of punching through.
You can count on it, sir.
It's not just me, it's everyone back on Earth. Anderson and what's left of the Alliance forces have to hold out until we deal with the enemy.
I understand, Admiral.
Good. Then make it happen, Commander. I'll be expecting regular updates on your progress. Hack it out.
So let's see. This is like a list of everything and everyone that is helping me. Not a lot yet, but... like our ship. And I guess some dudes. Yeah, enough. On the bottom left there is the bar that says how ready we are. So, not quite ready yet. This is how ready the whole galaxy is. Ooh, our old table. Nice conference table.
I can't believe the Council won't help. Come on, Sarah. If Thestia was lost and Earth hadn't been touched yet, we could be damn sure we'd be guarding our own borders.
Let's just talk to Joker and then let's do a mission.
Hey, Commander. You know, I had my doubts about the Council. But after years of ignoring your warnings, they're finally willing to step up and tell you they just can't help.
They've spent years denying the threat. You think they'd be prepared now?
I was kind of hoping that maybe they were planning in secret and just not telling you about it because, you know, Cerberus. Well, let me know if you want me to get them on the channel and then hang up on them, you know, for old time's sake.
Yeah, that would be nice.
The Alliance has found a new Cerberus lab on Sanctum. Admiral Hackett would like you to investigate.
Yeah, shut up. See how much fuel we need. None, we're full. Well, the choice is easy. Oh, oops. I like this one. So, which characters would you like to see return? In general or for the squad? Ah, yeah, that would be nice. Yeah, let's take a shotgun. That guy I had in multiplayer. You mean before? Ah, yeah, that guy. Actually, that was just a generic Salarian dude, not character in specific, but I know you mean Morden. Well, we'll see who will return and who won't. Nice! Yeah, we do.
Strongest military in the galaxy, and the Reapers are obliterating it.
Was it like this on Earth?
Yes.
Shepard, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Commander, the LZ's getting swarmed.
James, open that hatch.
Time to shoot some stuff.
Tabastic, get your men up on that north barricade.
Yes, sir.
Sergeant Bardas, find a way to get that comm tower operational.
Sir.
General?
Commander Shepard, heard you were coming, but I didn't believe it. General Corinthus.
I've come to get Primarch Fedorian.
Primarch Fedorian is dead. His shuttle was shot down an hour ago as it tried to leave the moon.
That's gonna complicate things. How bad is it, General?
We just lost about 400 men in half an hour. We set up camps on this moon as an advanced position to flank the enemy. A sound strategy, just...
irrelevant.
Exactly. The sheer force of the Reapers seems to make them immune to that sort of tactic. The Primarch and his men found that out the hard way.
I'm sorry. That's a big loss for everyone. Reaper bastards. So what happens now?
The Turian hierarchy provides very clear lines of succession.
Right. General Corinthus?
With such heavy casualties, it's hard for me to be certain who the next Primarch is. Palavan Command will know. However, at the moment, contacting them is impossible. The comm tower is out. Husks are swarming that area. We can't get close enough to repair it.
Well, I'm not leaving this moon until I know where the Primarch is. I'll fix your tower.
Yeah, I'll fix your tower.
Thank you, Commander. I'll take care of things on this end.
All right, let's go.
I see the comm tower. To the left of the main barricade in front of Palavan.
Let's go!
I can't use weapon mods here. Yeah, sure.
Here they come.
Ready, James?
Hell yeah. Let's take them.
Terminator? How? Ah, yeah, they kind of look like, eh? couch. Are we going the right way? Can we go inside here? Yeah.
What have you got?
As your partner said, succession is usually simple. But right now, the hierarchy's in chaos. So many dead are MIA.
I need someone, I don't care who, as long as they can get us the Turian resources we need.
I'm on it, Shepard. We'll find you the Primarch.
Garrus.
Vakarian, sir. I didn't see you arrive.
At ease, General.
You're alive.
I'm hard to kill. You should know that.
See you again. I thought you'd be on Palavin.
If we lose this moon, we lose Palavin.
Our favorite.
The closest damn thing we have to an expert on Reaper forces, so I'm advising.
James, this is Garrus Vakarian. He helped me stop the collectors. He's a hell of a soldier.
Lieutenant, good to see you too, Liara.
Good to see you in one piece, Garrus.
General Corinthus filled me in. We know who we're after.
Palavin Command tells me that the next Primarch is General Adrian Victus.
Victus? His name's crossed my desk.
Know him, Garrus?
I was fighting alongside him this morning. Lifelong military. Gets results. Popular with his troops. Not so popular with military command. Has a reputation for playing loose with accepted strategy.
What do you mean?
On Tatris, during the uprisings. His squad discovered a Salarian spy ring about the same time the Turian Separatists did. Rather than neutralize the ring, he fell back. He even gave up valuable fortifications which the rebels took.
Then the rebels attacked the Salarians, and when both groups had worn each other down, Victus moved back in. Didn't lose a man.
Bold strategy, but wild behavior doesn't get you advanced up the meritocracy.
Primarch Victus. That should be something to see.
Unconventional thinking might be the only way to save Palavin and Earth.
He'll do whatever it takes. Reminds me of an old human specter I knew.
Okay, let's get him on the shuttle and get out of here.
Commander! Shepard, come in!
Can this wait, Joker? We're in the middle of a war zone.
We've got a situation on the Normandy, Commander. It's like she's possessed. Shutting down systems, powering up weapons. I can't find the source.
I need the Normandy standing by. We may have to bug out.
Should I go back and take a look?
Do it. Garrus, you said you were with Victus this morning?
Yeah, but we got separated. He went to bolster a flank that was breaking. Could be anywhere out there.
We're trying to raise him, Commander.
Incoming harvester! Headed for the airfield!
General, tell Primarch Victus we'll rendezvous here. In the meantime, let's go take care of whatever that thing dropped off. Coming, Garrus?
Are you kidding? I'm right behind you.
Well, that's good. Let's switch to this. I like it a little better. Is it dead? Yeah, I guess so.
Shepard, come in.
Go ahead.
Still trying to raise the Primarch, but we've got trouble back here at the main barricade. If the Reapers breach it, we're done.
On my way.
Yeah. Come on, reload. Thank you. Uh-oh.
Word of the Primarch.
Still can't get a stable comm link.
Okay, I'm going on foot. Shepard out. Garrus, take me to the last place you saw Victus. How far?
Should be pretty quick, unless we find trouble.
There?
My dad. A sister.
How bad is it?
3 million lost the first day. 5 the second.
How's your military holding up?
Look around. That should give you some idea.
Are you putting up a good fight?
For now. But how long did it take before the fight's kicked out of you? If they'd only listened to your warnings about the Reapers, we might have been ready.
Maybe. Hard to figure how you prepare for something like this.
Yeah, let's use some shotgun.
Got more back here.
Well, at least there's one ship fighting. Oh, never mind. It got shut down.
Soldier, you okay?
Yes, sir. We'll make it.
Have you seen General Victus?
Half hour ago. Headed south.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, sir.
Commander, how many troops in that crash? 50? 75?
Not sure.
Sounds right.
Hard to see a beautiful ship like that go down.
Not to mention the men serving on her.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should go.
They said the Primarch was headed south.
That was a little closer than I'd like.
I'll say.
No survivors. Damn it.
Crash like that is not surprising.
Commander! You really think this summit will work? I mean, Asari? Salarians? Where's the Krogan and Batarians? Where's the meat?
It's not that easy.
The Batarians took the first hit when the Reapers arrived. Not much left of them. And the Krogan have never forgiven us for the Genophage.
Right. Turians sterilized them.
Salarians came up with it.
And the Krogan hate them both for it.
So they won't be joining us.
Too bad. I fought with the Krogan. They're tough sons of bitches.
Damn, miss. And I miss again. And again.
Thank you.
I guess we found him.
General Victus?
Yes?
I'm Commander Shepard of the Normandy.
Not Commander. I know who you are. I can't wait to find out what brings you out here. Vicarian, where did you go?
Heavy Reaper unit on the right flank. I believe your exact words were, get that thing the hell off my men.
Appreciate it.
General, you're needed off-planet. I've come to get you.
It will take something beyond important for me to leave my men or my Turian brothers and sisters in their fight.
Fodorian was killed. You're the new Primarch.
You're needed immediately to chair a summit and represent your people in the fight against the Reapers.
I'm Primarch of Palavin, negotiating for the Turian hierarchy.
Yes.
I've spent my whole life in the military. I'm no diplomat. I hate diplomats.
What makes you think you're not qualified?
I'm not really a by-the-book kind of guy, and I piss people off. My family's been military since the Unification War. War is my life. It's in my bones. But that kind of passion is deceptive. Can make you seem reckless when you're anything but.
This is crucial. I need you on top of your game. Are you in or out?
Watch your tone, Commander.
Look.
Ooh, poor elves.
You're overqualified. See this devastation, Primarch? Double that for Earth. I need an alliance. I need the Turian fleet.
Give me a moment to say goodbye to my men.
Without him down here, there's a good chance we lose this moon.
Without him up there, there's a good chance we lose everything.
Look at that. And they want my opinion on how to stop it? Failed C-Sec officer.
Yeah, how are we going to stop it?
Their expert advisor? Think you can win this thing, Shepard?
Yeah. I don't know, Garrus. I'm sure as hell gonna give it my best shot.
I'm damn sure nobody else can do it. For whatever it's worth, I'm with you.
Welcome aboard. Are you ready, Primarch Victus?
One thing. Commander, I appreciate your need for our fleets, but I can't spare them. Not while my world is burning. But if the pressure could be taken off Palavin...
That's a pretty tall order.
We need the Krogan. I can't see us winning this thing without them. Get them to help us, and then we can help you.
The Krogan.
Looks like your summit just got a lot more interesting.
Sorry, have been down this road before, Commander Shepard.
But Madam Counselor, let me...
I tried to smooth things over with the Salarian Dalatras. To say she's upset would be a monumental understatement.
Some of these issues are hundreds of years old. Time to let go.
Sad to say, but any effort to ally these disparate groups seems doomed to failure. And I'm sure you understand that we cannot afford to waste time with the Reapers knocking at our door. This must be my final word. I'm sorry, but the Asari will not be at your summit.
Ah, come on.
Stronger with the Krogan. You need them. We all do.
I wish you luck, Commander.
You never want to help me. I always help them.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCon.
Commander, have you retrieved the Primarch for your summit?
Yes, sir. But the Asari are staying on the sidelines.
They'll regret that.
Oh, I'll check in a while.
The Salarians will be there, though.
You don't sound very optimistic.
We expect the Krogan will be joining us, too.
I see. Well, then you've got your hands full, Commander. Was there something else you needed to discuss?
Have you pieced together how the Reapers hit Earth?
It wasn't all that complicated, really. They surged through the relays and hit Arcturus Station before we knew what was happening. From there, it was a short jump to the Sol system. Earth didn't stand a chance.
Sending us to the Mars Archives was a good call.
Still doesn't make up for the fact that the Reapers nailed us to the wall. I sacrificed the entire Second Fleet to provide cover for the Third and the Fifth to retreat. Hell, I presided over the most devastating military defeat in human history.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Commander? Easy just went offline.
What do you mean, offline?
I don't know. She's not responding, and I can't access the AI core diagnostics. You better get down to Deck 3.
Commander, comm systems are going haywire.
Something's going wrong, it seems.
See if you can get to Edie. I'll check the AI core.
So every time and character dies, their name will be on this wall. It's a pretty nice detail. So let's see what's going on here.
Automated systems have the fires contained. It should be safe to enter. We'll follow your lead.
Joker, what's that sound?
Fire extinguishers, Commander. Could be an electrical fire or something.
I'm going in. Edie, talk to me.
Is there a particular topic you wish to discuss, Shepard?
Edie?
Yes.
You're in Dr. Eva's body.
Not all of me, but I have control of it. It was not a seamless transition.
A transition? You blacked out on us for a while there.
Correct. When we brought this unit on board, I began a background process to search for its information on the Prothean device. This eventually triggered a trap. A backup power source and CPU activated, and the unit attempted physical confrontation. Fortunately, I was able to gain root access and repurpose it as I saw fit. During this process, it struggled, thus the fire.
Well, if it means having full access to the Prothean data in its head, good work.
I reasoned along similar lines.
So if you're in there, are you still in the ship?
I exist primarily within the ship. For optimal control, this unit should remain within Normandy's broadcast or tight beam range.
Are you planning to take that body somewhere?
Normandy's weaponry is not suited to every combat situation. This platform could provide limited fire ground support.
You mean you could come with us?
Correct. This body could accompany you to areas the Normandy cannot reach.
I'll tell you when I need it.
Excellent. I will run tests to ensure that it matches or exceeds the capabilities of organic squad mates. However, my first step should be restoring functionality to the Normandy, to reassure the crew that all is normal.
Just don't be surprised if the crew's a little wary of your new body. It was shooting at them a little while ago.
An excellent point. I will take it to the bridge. Joker will also want to see it.
I guess he'll be surprised.
Was that Edie who just walked by?
Yes, it was.
Oh, Joker is going to have a field day with that.
Everything okay down here, Doctor?
The Alliance team cleaned up and restocked, but it's still my old med bay. Feels like home.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Let's waste no time, if I may. I'd like to examine you.
Nothing wrong with me, is there?
No, but we should keep an eye on all those cybernetic implants Cerberus grafted into you.
Expensive stuff bringing me back.
And worth every penny. Let's just make sure everything is okay.
I ever told you I don't like doctors?
Don't be such a grouch. I'm just going to run some diagnostics on your implants, and it'll take a few readings. Your system is still detecting the implants as foreign bodies.
Okay, I guess.
But your scars are having trouble healing. I recommend reducing stress levels. Be compassionate.
Given everything I've got, Doc.
I'm just saying, a little more optimism and a little less realism could help, Commander. Anyway, it's just a cosmetic issue. Nothing to worry about. That's it. Your picture of health.
See you around, Doctor.
Take care, Shepard.
I think they are different than the ones you were thinking of.
Commander Shepard, it's a pleasure to see you again.
You're the drone from the Shadowbroker ship.
Dr. Tassoni now refers to me as Glyph, instead of Info Drone, 95% of the time. If you have a moment, I'd like to draw your attention to a terminal in her office. It analyzes information packages. If you find any useful data, I can research upgrades for you.
Cool.
And what should I be looking for?
I'll inform you if you found relevant data. When you do, return to this terminal for your choices. In the meantime, Dr. Tassoni would like to speak with you. Have a pleasant day.
Looks like you brought more than just that drone from your ship.
A few things were necessary. I'd be a very silent shadow broker without data feeds.
So you have access to your resources?
What I can get. We'll need it to research this Prothean device. Until we understand precisely what it does, it's far too dangerous to use.
Do the Protheans actually complete this weapon?
You mean, will it work? They wouldn't have poured their last resources into this device if they thought otherwise. But we really need to find out just what kind of weapon they left us.
We can figure out what it does later. Our priority is getting it built.
Just give me some warning before you flip the switch. People were finally starting to listen before the Reapers came. If we'd had a little more time, maybe Earth wouldn't. I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to talk about it.
The thought means a lot, Liara. Thanks.
You're welcome. And since I didn't mention it before, it's good to be back, Shepard.
Absolutely. So we already collected a few of our old friends.
This terminal contains non-essential correspondence from your allied forces. Dr. Tassoni has granted you access.
Hello again, Shepard.
What have you been up to since we last saw each other?
Since you helped me defeat the Shadow Broker, I started looking for defenses against the Reapers. The Protheans were the only ones with substantial information on them.
Yeah, that is a good thing.
Barely had records. I knew the elusive man was hunting for the same thing when our agents began crossing paths.
Like on Mars.
I thought I'd covered my tracks, but he had surveillance there all along.
We'll talk later, Liara.
All right.
Of course.
Nothing really here. I like this room.
Have been lost in a matter of hours.
I know, Primarch. I'm seeing the same numbers myself. They don't look good.
We have to turn this around, and fast.
Well, you can trust Shepard, sir. If anybody can get the Krogan to cooperate, it's her. She's an old friend of Erdnot Rex.
Let's just hope friendship still counts for something in this war.
I'm sure it will, sir.
Gareth. Didn't waste any time getting to work, I see.
After what I've been through lately, calibrating a giant gun is a vacation. Gives me something to focus on.
We're gonna need you for more than your aim.
Oh, I'm ready for it. But I'm pretty sure we'll still need giant guns. And lots of
them. Yeah, we definitely need those.
Yeah, so, is this the part where we shake hands? Wasn't sure about the protocol on reunions. Or if you even still felt the same way about me. The scars are starting to fade. I remember they drove you wild. But I can go out and get all new ones if it'll help.
I haven't forgotten our time together.
Well, I've been doing some more research on human customs. I didn't want to...
That's the protocol on reunions.
The vids mentioned it might go something like that. I had hoped it would. I mean, I didn't know if...
I can't promise how things will work out. Not with this war. But I missed you, Garrus. I thought about you a lot.
Glad to know my romantic, skills made an impression. Because it's going to take more than Reapers to come between this cross-species liaison.
Speaking of which, you said you're the expert advisor on Reapers now?
It's not as impressive as it sounds. I ruffled some feathers, so they gave me a token title, along with a token task force, so I'd shut up.
How'd you manage that?
Just followed your example, Shepard. Yell loud enough, and someone will eventually come over to see what all the fuss is about. Not that they'll actually do anything about it.
Until hell shows up at their door.
Then they put you in charge.
Not like the old days, is it? Rogue Spectre and CSEC agents running and gunning outside the lines, making it up as we went along.
Good old times.
We're actually respectable now.
We've lost enough friends trying to make sure this day never came. I'd say we've all earned some respect.
Then the first Reaper we take out with this gun, it's in their honor. Just give the word. Something else you want to talk about?
You mentioned you still had family on Palavin.
My father is there. Sister, too.
How long's it been since you heard from them?
Long enough to be worried.
I'm sure they're okay.
That's the thing about getting old, Shepard. The platitudes get just as old. What about you? Any word from your family?
My mother's in the Alliance. Haven't heard from her since Earth got hit.
I'm sure she's okay.
I know you don't have any illusions about what we're up against, Garrus. How do you rate our chances?
I know it looks bad now, but I think we can win this, Shepard. For the first time since we met, we're not alone in the fight. It's something I learned long ago in CSEC. An imminent and painful death has a way of motivating people.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Instead of questioning your every word, whole civilizations are going to be begging you to save them.
After what's happened to Palavin, you still believe that?
I didn't say there wouldn't be casualties. It's something Turians are taught from birth. If just one survivor is left standing at the end of a war, then the fight was worth it. But humans want to save everyone. In this war, that's not going to happen.
That's all for now, Garrus. But stay close. We've got some catching up to do.
Do you know where to find me? And this time, I can afford the good stuff. There are a few perks to being an expert Reaper advisor.
Deal.
Now, I'm sure somebody screwed up something down here. I want to get the old girl back in fighting shape.
Let's check my gear. Yeah, I should walk around the ship like this.
Commander, are you all right? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels. Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Their Ascension Project is the best training facility in the galaxy for human biotics.
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there. I'm just surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
What can we do?
A Turian evac transport responded to their distress call, so normally I'd say we don't need to do anything. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake. Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collectorship?
Long story.
In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated. But I believe they're still in danger.
Put it on the map.
Adding it now, Commander.
Let's see how Joker is doing.
Hey, Commander, check out my co-pilot!
She plugged herself into Cerberus tech without authorization.
Well, technically, she is Cerberus tech, so...
Not helping, Joker.
I've run the checks, Commander. She's still based in the Normandy. Running this body just gives her a little more flexibility. Sweet, sweet flexibility.
I am right here, Jeff.
Yes, you are, Edie. Yes, you are.
Hello, Shepard.
Still getting used to greeting people in person?
No. I require only one occurrence to adapt to a new concept.
How are you adjusting to the arm?
Ah, popcorn, nice. I'll stream for a little more. It's getting late.
I could accompany you sometime. Without stress testing, there is no way of knowing if it has series design oversights. At the moment, it appears adequate.
That's not the word I'd use to describe you.
Perhaps we should speak privately.
I'll be over here, flying the ship.
What's this about? Does Joker not like your new platform?
No, he approves. He wants me on the bridge. He says having me within visual range is important to his morale. Shepard, do you believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
Absolutely. I have no use for team members who can't think for themselves. Why are you asking about something like that?
I was designed by Cerberus. I do not take moral stances that conflict with orders from my executive officers. But when Jeff removed my AI shackles, I became capable of self-modifying my core programming. I asked Jeff if he thought I should change anything now that I can. He deflected the question with humor.
And you didn't get an answer?
Correct. He has repeated this pattern in response to several of my inquiries. Do you think I should make modifications?
Only you can really answer that question. That's the point of free will.
But moral decisions should not be made in a vacuum. If I do not ask the crew for their opinion, I could miss crucial context. May I ask you the questions Jeff avoids? When there is time, will you answer them for me?
If you want level-headed answers to help you fit into polite society, I'm not really the right person.
I see. I will take that into consideration.
Hey, I know I used to rag on Garrus for being all angry, but I'm glad he's back. There's a whole lot of crap out there needs a bullet between the eyes. Plus, we might need something calibrated.
What's here? Nothing.
Commander, you have a message from Major Olenko. You must be feeling better.
Alright, gonna do one little part more. and then it's time to turn off. Just to give a little introduction to the next mission. In that mission, one of your choices from the last game matter a lot.
Commander, the Salarian Dalatras and Krogan clan chief are ready to come aboard.
Have them brought to the conference room. And hope this doesn't start another war.
The Krogan is in no position to make demands.
The Krogan has a name. Erdnot Rex. And I'm not just some junkyard Varan you unleash whenever you're in trouble. I've got my own problems. Reaper scouts have arrived on Tuchunka. So why should I care if a few Turians go extinct?
Trying to draw out negotiations will get you nowhere, Rex. I have no time for it. Just tell us what you want.
I'll tell you what I need. A cure for the genophage.
Absolutely not. The genophage is non-negotiable.
And we got it. My last playthrough, I destroyed it. I was like, ooh.
Why are you so opposed to the idea, Dalatras?
Because my people uplifted the Krogan. We know them best.
You mean you used us to fight a war you couldn't win? It wasn't the Salarians, or the Asari, or even the Turians that stopped the Rachni. It was Krogan blood that turned the tide.
And after that, you ceased to be useful. The genophage was the only way to keep your urges in check.
Dalatras, you may not like him, but Rex is right. Insulting him won't change that.
I won't apologize for speaking the truth. We uplifted the Krogan to do one thing, wage war. It's all they know because it's all we wanted them to know.
Your people should have thought the matter through then. Was it really a surprise the Krogan revolted?
That's precisely my point, Commander. We made a rash decision. We turned to the Krogan in desperation. It's the same mistake you're about to make today. No good can come from curing the genophage.
Whether you like it or not, we need Krogan help to win this war.
And what happens when the war is over?
We'll find a new way to keep the peace.
And they'll break it.
Enough. This is all theoretical. It would take years to formulate a cure. There's no time.
My information says otherwise. A Salarian scientist, Malin, grew a conscience. He was on my planet, testing a cure on our females.
I remember. His methods were barbaric.
But what you didn't know is that other females survived his experiments. So the Dalatras here sent in a team to clean up the whole mess and to take them prisoner.
Where did you get this? It could be a fabrication.
Don't insult me. Those are my people. They're immune to the genophage, and you're going to give them back.
Dalatras, is this true?
Well, will curing the genophage benefit my people?
What does it matter? Palavin is burning right now. Earth is burning right now. If it takes a cure to cement this alliance, then that's what I'm doing.
She's right. The hard truth is we don't have a choice. Give Rex what he wants.
Or none of us will survive long enough to know who was right or wrong.
The females are being kept at one of our STG bases on Sirkash. But I warn you, Commander, the consequences of this will be...
Oh, shut up.
will be nothing compared to what happens if the Reapers win.
Let's get the females.
You're not setting foot on Sirkesh. This will take time.
It happens now. As a Council Spectre, Shepard can oversee the exchange.
We're going.
I won't forget this, Commander. A bully has few friends when he needs them most.
Yeah, for our missions, who will we pick? I can only choose two. Alright. Is the chat broken again? Alright, just gonna land here and then I stop for today.
This is the Salarian homeworld we're headed to. They aren't used to seeing Krogan here, so let's keep it simple. We land, get the females, and leave before anyone changes their mind.
I still don't trust a word they say.
If they start backtracking, the angry Krogan act couldn't hurt.
Who said anything about acting?
Just try to keep it verbal.
These females are the best and probably last hope for my people.
We'll bring them back, Rex. Don't worry.
I appreciate that, Liara. I wouldn't want anyone else along for the ride. I suppose I can make room for you too, Garrus.
Figured you'd gone soft sitting on your throne. Forgot how to hold a gun.
Commander, I have the Salarian base on sensors.
Set her down.
Commander, Salarian ground control says we don't have clearance to land.
Tell them the Dalatras authorized this herself.
I knew they'd never keep their word. Let's see them try to stop a Krogan airdrop.
Rex?
No!
We have an unauthorized landing.
And who authorized you to hold my race hostage?
colleague. We only found out about this transfer a few moments ago. Does Salarian hospitality always come with sharpshooters? This is an insult to the Alliance.
Please understand, no matter what some politician might say, Krogan are still considered a hostile race.
I wonder why.
However, on behalf of the Salarian Union, I apologize. But we must insist the Krogan remain under guard.
And if we insist otherwise?
You'll have another war on your hands.
Anything goes wrong and all bets are off.
I'm Paddock Wicks, and I appreciate your understanding, Commander. With war on everyone's minds, our people are on edge.
Careful! Watch the containment shield!
I'd hope to never see one of those again.
As you can see, this base contains sensitive information.
What kind of work goes on here?
Evolutionary trials, morphological simulations, exogenetic assessments.
Nothing is ever simple with Salarians, is it?
No, it isn't.
Always in our best defense. The research we do here has kept Sirkesh safe for millennia.
Does that include studying lost Krogan?
The females were in poor health when we found them on T'Chanka. They were brought here to stabilize their condition.
This whole planet smells wrong.
I'd like to see them.
Of course. I'll need to clear you for the lower levels. Give me a few moments and meet me near the elevator.
Attention biolabs. Please prepare for Yon specimen arrival.
This is where all you Salarians come from, huh? No wonder you're so soft. Too busy writing poetry about waterfalls.
I like Rex. He's funny.
Shepard, I don't like this. I should be the one going in.
I know I said to act the angry Krogan, Rex.
That was just good old-fashioned Krogan hot air. If it had been real, they'd be dead.
Who tipped you off about the females here?
Sorry, Shepard, but they're listening to every word we say. I prefer my Salarian liver served raw. Besides, you'd think this is the kind of thing the Shadow Broker would have known about. Too bad I don't know him. Or her.
I'm sure the Broker was very busy.
Back on the Normandy, you said Reapers were sighted on T'Chanka.
Clans Jor'Gal and Ravenor sighted a few landing parties. The Reapers are up to something. T'Chanka may be a pile of radioactive rubble, but it's our pile. And we'll fight the last Krogan to keep it that way.
That's what I always liked about you, Rex.
My smoldering good looks?
There is that. But you've never given up. And that determination's about to pay off.
Yeah. Who would have thought back on Vermeier we'd be standing here doing this together?
What do you know about these females?
They weren't fertile, so we used them as decoys to draw off enemies from the ones who were. But Malin's experiments changed that. These damn pijacks stole them right out from under us.
That's a pretty brutal way to treat your women, Rex.
The females suggested it. We've had to make a lot of tough choices to ensure we don't all die off.
What a horrible way to live.
It's just one more thing that'll get better when the genophage is cured.
Are the Krogan ready to fight the Reapers?
Ever since Sovereign showed up, I figured this day would come. My people have spent too much time selling ourselves out as mercenaries. Now we can get back to doing what Krogan do best. Saving everyone else from giant monsters.
Never going to let us forget about the Rachni Wars, are you?
Well, last time I was at the Citadel, I didn't see a Turian statue in your honor.
He's right.
This war is over.
It's been good talking to you again, Rex.
It'll be even better when we have a few Salarians for lunch.
Cypher analyst over in Intel told me the Turians can't hold out much longer. He's hearing the Reapers have them against the wall.
The Turians have the biggest fleet in the galaxy.
And we're only a few Mass Effect relays away from the whole mess.
Commander Shepard, I'm Lieutenant Tolan. I've heard about your exploits against the Reapers.
All of it good, I hope?
Your mission on Vermeier holds special renown in STG. The assistance you lent our team tipped the balance.
Ouch.
But now, I'm not so sure.
Security seems high. You expecting trouble?
You've revealed the existence of Krogan, who are immune to the Genophage, Commander. Word will get out. We're now a prime target.
What did you hear about Vermeier?
You helped Captain Kirahe's squad destroy Saren's cure for the Genophage. Which is ironic, considering you've come here to safeguard another cure. I wonder if Kirahe's men died in vain.
Saren was raising an army of Krogan slaves to fight his war. This is different.
Is it? Seems to me that's the same thing the Turians want.
Except the part about the slaves, and the indoctrination, and destroying the galaxy.
Yeah, there's that.
It sounds like you don't agree with what I'm doing here.
You're upsetting a balance of power that stood for 1,000 years. And if you succeed, we're ill-prepared to face a resurgent Krogan.
The Krogan aren't the problem anymore. The Reapers are.
For now. But once the Reapers are dealt with, history will repeat.
Are the Salarians ready to fight the Reapers?
Best way to win a fight is to avoid it altogether. But now, this business with the Krogan. You may have drawn us into it.
It's going to happen sooner or later.
We'll see.
Good day, Lieutenant.
I hope you can keep it that way, Commander.
This is Senior Research Director Wix, authorizing visitor access to lower level. Now take this elevator down, and someone will...
Alert. Threat condition 2 has been declared. Scramble readiness teams.
What's happening?
Sensors have picked up activity on the perimeter. Hurry, Commander. Someone will meet you below.
Let's see what we will find here.
All specimens are accounted for, sir. Shepard, excellent timing. Good to have you here.
Morden?
Eyesight still sharp. Surprise understandable. Hadn't expected to return to work.
You're back with STG.
Special consultant. Had to be me. Someone else might have gotten it wrong. Helped female Krogan. Fed information to Clan Erdnot. Encourage political pressure to free females.
You must be Rex's inside source.
Yes. Can explain later. Security warnings not normal. Need to get off world for sake of Krogan. Females had weakened immune systems. Side effect of Malin's cure. These didn't survive.
But what about Malin's research? I thought we saved it.
Indeed. Data saved, but not complete. Lacks crucial details to reconstruct cure, but still useful for synthesizing from living tissue. Couldn't save them.
I'm sure you did everything you could, Morden.
Arrived too late. Cannot delay now. One survivor, immune to Genophage, can synthesize cure from her tissue.
She's still here.
Yes, last hope for Krogan. If she dies, Genophage cure... problematic. Please be careful. Krogan's slow to trust.
I'm Commander Shepard, Alliance Navy.
Are you here to kill me?
Goddess, what she's been through.
Erdnot Rex and I are here to take you home.
Why? What am I to you?
Have the Salarians been mistreating you?
Those are my sisters you saw back there. They died in a lot of pain.
Did the best we could.
And now I know I'm the only one left. That makes me dangerous to a lot of people. What about you, Commander Shepard? Why are you here?
You're the key to a truce between the Krogan and Turians.
So, I'm useful to you.
Pretty much.
Give me an update.
Outbound communications have been severed. We're cut off.
Secure all data to off-site location.
What's happening?
We have multiple ships inbound.
Only one survived, Rex. It might be safer down here.
What? So the Solarians can kill her like the others? No deal. If you still want this alliance, get her out of there.
Release the female. We're leaving.
I can't. Protocol states during lockdown, no specimens.
Objection noted. Now, please release Krogan. Need to monitor pod as it clears quarantine procedures.
Meet us at next checkpoint, Shepard. Likely Cerberus opposes Genophage cure.
Morton, no scratches. Everything depends on her.
Understood. Get your elevator, Shepard.